In this video, I am going to discuss about how to solve the problems on design of flat belt. Let us see a problem. Design a belt drive to transmit 22 kilowatt at 740 rpm to an aluminium rolling machine, the speed ratio being 3.0, the distance between the pulley is 3 meter, diameter of the rolling machine pulley is 1.2 meter. Here the power is 22 kilowatt at 740 rpm. So P is equal to 22 kilowatt and rpm speed of the driver member. So 740 rpm and speed ratio I is equal to 3 mm. The distance between the pulley is 3 meter, that is C is equal to 3 meter. Then the diameter of the rolling machine. The rolling machine is the driven member. So the diameter is capital D equal to 1.2 meter. From this, we're going to find out the width and the length of the belt. First, the width of the belt equal to design power by the belt rating. Here the design power means is the product of the rated power multiplied with service factor multiplied with arc of contact factor. The rated power means the power given in the problem, that is 22 kilowatt. Then the service factor and arc of contact factor are going to be selected from the design data book based on the values. Here the belt rating is based on the belt selections. We can select. So the design power is 22 kilowatt. Then the service factor from the page number we already discussed in the previous previous PowerPoint. At the page number 7.53, so the rolling machine, the service factor is 1.5. Then the arc of contact theta. We have the formula from the data book. So 180 minus capital T minus small d by C into 60. From the page number 7.54, we know the value of capital D and small c. Then the unknown parameter is only small d, diameter of the driver member. So whereas we know the speed ratio, I is equal to capital D by small d. So we know the capital D and I. So from this we can find out the smaller d. So the diameter of the driver member we can find out easily, that is for 400 mm. So by using this formula we can find out that is theta is equal to 164. So based on this theta from the page number 7.54 we can find out the arc of contact factor. For 164 we can select the arc of contact factor Ka is equal to 1.06. So we already find out the service factor as 1.5. Now the arc of contact factor 1.08. We already have the rated power. So the design power is equal to the multiplication of these. So DP is equal to 35 kilowatt. Then we have to find out the belt rating. So for belt rating, we need the number of plies and velocity. So the for number of we know already. Then for the number of plies, we should know the velocity of the diameter of the driver member and the velocity of the belt. So the velocity of the belt B is equal to pi dn by 60. By using this, we can find out as 15.5 meter per second. Here the 15.5 meter per second, this is based on this velocity and the diameter D is equal to 400 mm. From the data book page number 7.52, we can select 6 plies. So number of plies is 6. Now assuming for this velocity 15.5 meter per second is greater than 10 meter per second, so we select Dunlop 949 gram duct belting, that is the second types of belt. So from the page number 7.54, the formula for the belt rating for the second type of belt, that is 949 gram belt rate, Dunlop belt, belt rating is equal to 0.0289 kilowatt per mm width per plies. Here we have a 6 plies and 10 meter per second. Here we have a 15 per meter per second and the belt speed is actually 15.5, and the arc of contact is 164, and the number of plies is 6. So based on this, we can find out as 0.245 kilowatt per mm width. So the required belt width is equal to rated power by the belt rating. So the rated power is 35 and the belt rating is 0.24 kilowatt per mm width. So from this, the required belt width is equal to 143 mm. From the page number 7.52, the next standard available belt width we can select it as 152 mm. Okay, and then the next ones we have already, now we find out the width of the belt. Then the length of the belt. From the page number 7.53, we can use the formula to find out the length of the belt. So from this, we already know all the parameters, that is center distance C, capital D, small d. So by using these variables, we can find out the length of the belt. L is equal to 8.566 meter. Due to the alternative contraction and expansions, the reduction of the length of the initial tension, we take it as 1% of L, since it is actually based on the number of plies. Here actually we selected 6 plies. So for 6 plies, the initial reduction in the length of the belt due to the initial tension is 1% of L, which is available at the page number 7.53. So the required length of the belt, final required length of the belt, L is equal to 8480 mm. Then pulley width, we already know the width of the belt. So based on this, the pulley width from the page number 7.54, the pulley width equal to belt width plus 25 mm. Since the thickness of the belt is greater than 120 mm, so we add 25 mm along with the belt width. So the belt pulley width is equal to 177 mm. Finally, we arrived the result like this. So length of the belt 8480 mm, width of the belt 152 mm, driver pulley diameter 400 and driven pulley diameter 1200 mm, and width of the pulley is 177 mm. Here there is in this problem they just ask design the belt. In some problems they also asked to design the design of pulley also. So in that cases we should consider the design of dimensions of arm, dimensions of rim, and as well as dimension of hub. Okay, next let's see next problem. A pulley of 900 mm diameter revolving at 200 rpm is to transmit 7.5 kilowatt. Find the width of the leather belt if the maximum tension is not to exceed 145 newton in 10 mm width. The tension on the tight side is twice that on the slack side. Determine the diameter of the shaft, the dimension of the various parts of the pulley, assuming if it has 6 arms. So maximum shear stress is not to exceed 63 MN per meter square, then allowable bending stress 50 Newton per mm square. So from this data, we first write down the given data. So power is 7.5 kilowatt, diameter, the pulley of 900 mm diameter revolving at 200 rpm is to transmit power 7.5. So the capital D is equal to 900 mm, since low speed driven member is rotating at lower speed compared with the driver member. So the given data speed is driven member speed and driven member diameter. Then the maximum tension is equal to 145 Newton in 10 mm width. So then T1 equal to 2 times of T2. Then number of ohms in the case of pulley design. So number of ohms is 6. Then shears stress is equal to as given, and similarly bending stress is given. Then in this here, based on the tension as given, so instead of data book, we try to solve by using the fundamental equations. So the width of the belt B is equal to bit of the belt is equal to design power of belt rating. So instead of the design power is equal to actual belt rating into service factor or curve content, we can straight away use the maximum tension, that is in the tight side tensions, then divided by the belt rating. So the power transmitted by the belt, that is equal to T1 minus T2 into B. So B is equal to pi dN by 60. From this we can find out B is equal to 9.426 meter per second. Then power already given, that is 7.5 kilowatt equal to T1 minus T2 into velocity. So from this T1 minus T2 we can find out. Then another condition has given in our problem, T1 equal to 2 times of T2. So that is, now we can substitute instead of T1. So from this we can find out T2 is equal to 796 Newton. Then we can find out T1 is equal to, so T1 and T2 we can find out from this equations. So the velocity of the belt, here the velocity of the belt is less than 10 meter per second. The centrifugal tension is neglected. Suppose if it is greater than 10 meter per second, we should add along with the T1 as well as T2. So the belt rating is equal to, which is given in our problem, that is equal to 145 Newton in 10 mm width. So we should convert it to per mm width. So 14.5 Newton per mm width. So from this, belt width is equal to maximum tension by belt rating. So the maximum tension is T1, that is tension in the tight side, by the belt rating is 14.5. So from this we can easily find out the belt width, that is B is equal to 109.8 mm. Then the standard width of the belt for 6 plies for both types of the belt, which is available at the page number 7.52, that is equal to 112 mm. Then the diameter of the shaft. Here the general formula for the power, P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60, where here the T is the torque transmitted by the shaft. So from this the torque we can find out as 358 into 10 power 3 Newton m. And another formula, T is equal to pi by 16 sigma s into ds cube. The ds is nothing but the diameter of the shaft. So from this formula we can find out the diameter, such as d is equal to 30.7, and the standard diameter of the shaft is 35 mm, which is available standardized from the page on the 7.20 page number. Then the dimensions of the pulley, here the pulley is 3 part rim arms and then the hub. First diameter, rim diameter, so from the page number 7.54, for the width up to 125 mm. So the width of the pulley, capital B, is equal to width of the belt plus 13. So the capital B is equal to 125, that is the width of the pulley. Then the thickness of the pulley, which is available at page number 7.57, T is equal to capital T by 200 plus 3 for the number of 6 plies. So from this, thickness of the rim, pulley rim is 7.5 mm. Similarly, the dimensions of the arm. So actually the dimension arm, it's actually elliptical cross section. So it has a major axis and minor axis. Here the major axis is x, minor axis is y. So the major axis is just, which is equal to 2 times of minor axis. So the sigma b is equal to 2 pi by n z, 2t by n z. T is the torque, then z is the section modulus for the elliptical cross sections. So using this relations we can find out the major axis and minor axis of the, that is x and y, or y dimensions of the arm. Similarly, dimensions of the hub. So by using the formula di, that is internal diameter or the shaft diameter, or both are same, the outer diameter is 1.5 ds plus 25 mm, or assume d naught is equal to outer diameter of the hub is equal to 2 times of shaft diameter. So based on this we can find out outer diameter 75 mm. Similarly, the length of the hub is 2/3 of b, that is width of the pulley. So from this l is equal to 85 mm. So likewise we can predict the dimensions of the pulleys and dimensions of the belt. Thank you. Actually, in this video, we discuss by using the fundamental equation, that is tensions and the PhD data books. Okay, we can solve the problem based on the given